time has come to build a new grow-out chicken coop. We've moved this thing out of the way, and it feels good to have this area cleaned back up and reclaimed. We've done a little research about what kind of grow-out chicken coop that we'd like to do, and we've decided to go with a design produced by Justin Rhodes. He's posted it online for free, and it's really, I think, quite brilliant. It's mostly designed to be able to rotate on different pasture land for different paddocks and give the chickens fresh grass for free ranging. We're not going to be doing that, but it'll still be nice to have sort of a mobile mini coop to move around occasionally and just let the chickens fertilize different areas of our property. Anyway, I'm back from my dad's. I used his table saw out there to cut some of the materials. Unfortunately, the camera I was using, the autofocus doesn't always work, so none of the video really came out. But you know, mostly I just cut up some plywood and some 2x4s into 2x2s, split one of the 2x2s down to two 1x2s, cut the roofing panels. Anyway, I'm back here now, and it's time to cut up some more materials. Justin Rhodes' instructions, I'm making things a little easier on myself by writing down on tape the length of the different pieces I'm cutting, so it's easy to grab later as I'm putting the mobile chicken coop together. I'm also setting aside some cut down pieces to my left in a scrap pile that's easy to grab from for cutting some smaller pieces in a little bit as well. parts of these directions are really sort of difficult to follow. I highly recommend laying out the parts that you're putting together before you actually screw them together, just so you can visualize exactly what's going on and how far up from one mark to go to the next, and it'll just save you some headaches if you have it spread out correctly on the table before you assemble these different parts. For this little swivel bar, I've tacked it together with a little bit of glue beforehand just to make it a little easier for myself. Corner posts are going to be put together like this just to make it easier on myself for screwing these things together. I'm going to use some other pieces of 2x4 just to hold it nice and flat, so it's I'm not having to kind of hold it awkward while I'm trying to screw these things together.
Thank you.
So it's the next day. I'm still building the mobile chicken coop. I'm building this project underneath my carport because it's flat and dry if it starts to rain. It's taken me a while to put this project together, so I'm using these garbage cans as safety cones just in case anybody pulls up the driveway. It's a loop. We don't want people racing around and running right into the Chickshaw here. Anyway, I wanted to point out a couple of mistakes I made yesterday. First one is kind of a dumb mistake. I put one of the two of the roosting bars on either end. And obviously where the corner posts go, that was going to be in the way for that. So super easy fix. I just pulled them out and kept on with the project. This other one was with the nesting box assembly, and the directions were a little more complicated there. I put these vertical supports in on that instead of on the wall of the chicken coop. I was just following the directions, and I thought I was still in the process of building that nesting box assembly, but it had moved on to the coop itself, and didn't realize that. So last night I just disassembled that a little bit, and I think I've got it back into working order. And so we'll keep on keeping on. I'm assembling a few smaller components here inside my shop just because it's easier for me to do this stuff using my workbench. a little earlier, I disassembled that old chicken tractor. It's pretty satisfying to finally get rid of that ugly thing. I didn't do any video of it, but I'll show you what it looks like after it's all taken apart. All right, now we can get back to building that mobile chicken coop. Thank you. So I was running out of daylight yesterday before I could get the roof on. We'll finish that up today. I just wanted to talk real briefly about the process of building this mobile chicken coop. I really like building these kind of projects. It's a lot of fun for me. One thing about picking out the lumber, plan on spending a lot of time looking at each board so you don't get any warped or twisted ones. I spend a lot of time at Lowe's digging through the pile of 2x4s to find the good ones. I had to get like most of the way through the pile and shift half of them back onto the pile afterwards just to get ones that were nice and straight. With this kind of a project, but building anything in general, the straighter the 2x4s are to begin with, the easier it's going to be for you. The design itself is great. I was a little skeptical at first when I was flipping the contraption over to work on one side or the other yesterday. It was so heavy, I was wondering, is this thing even going to be really that mobile after all? But once the wheels are on and you've got the handle installed, it's a breeze to move around. It's just super easy. If I was going to do it again, I think I might make it a little taller. Might be nice to have a little more headroom for the chickens. And weight, obviously, wouldn't be an issue. You'd have to buy more materials and change all the plans to do that. But I think it's going to be a good design overall. This is kind of a cool feature. You can hang a bucket on the handles like that, or just like that, for feed or whatever you might need to move around with your chickens. Yeah, I think that's pretty cool. Done. I had run out of washers yesterday, and my dad's gonna come over today to pick something up. He's also bringing me some more washers so I can finish that up today. I prefer using the screws and washers to those hardware cloth staples. Just something I like better. Thank you. buy these milk crates from Amazon or wherever it was that Justin Rhodes had recommended. My dad happened to have these at his place that he wasn't using. Anyway, these things are almost perfect and they're gonna work great, I think. One slight problem with them though is they sort of fall through and get a little cattywampus. So we're gonna put in this perforated masonite as a decking just to keep them nice and flush on the nesting roosting area. Also, I'm a little concerned about predators being able to paw at and pull out the nesting boxes. We have coyotes and raccoons. I think they'd probably be resourceful enough to do that. And then the chickens would be in danger. So I was trying to figure out a good way to secure the nesting boxes. And it's the obvious choice is to use the other half of the chain link fence rail that I use for the handlebar in the front as a blocking rail in the back. So I'll put that in as well. I think that'll work. It's a little bit more difficult to get in and out of the nest boxes for me, but I think that's worth it to keep the predators away from the chickens. So my mom has come in from Central Oregon. It's nice to see her. She doesn't get up here as often as when she used to live just down in Salem. And now we get to see the mobile chicken coop. So this is what it is, and I'll show you how it works here.
Okay.
If you want to let the chickens out for free ranging, this just folds down. Really easy for them to get in and out. And it's just, you know, it just moves around on the two wheels like a cart, and it's remarkably light and easy to maneuver for its size. And I also put in this bar for the hanging feeder.
What's this?
That's water for the chickens. We'll see how that works. It's not a real big water, but I'm hoping that it doesn't freeze because it's one of those insulated kind of thermos type waterers. So I'll show you how it moves.
Okay.
You want to hold the camera?
Sure. Just, just set the kickstand again. So I've had a few days to practice moving this around and try it in different spots. And I think overall, I've changed my mind. If I had this to do over again, I might make it a little bit smaller. On our place out here, where I'm gonna wanna put this, this mini coop, is kind of back in some forest type areas, and the size of it is a little difficult to maneuver around trees and bushes and to get into different tight spots, but it's really a very good design overall, and I'm super happy with it. Anyway, there's just one last thing to do, and I'll let you watch as I do that. One last point about our Mini Cooper. The chickens really make a big mess with their hanging feeder. Back in the regular chicken coop, it doesn't really matter. The food falls out, it just hits the floor and they eat it off the floor. But in this coop, the food falls through the grate and it goes to waste. After moving it around a little bit, it just kind of bothered me how much food we were buying
that was just hitting the ground and feeding the squirrels. So we're using this tub, which is just the right size to slip underneath the coop, right underneath where that feeder sits, to catch the extra food that falls through. We then, from time to time, just dump it into the chicken run. There's a little bit of chicken poop that gets in here, but who cares if there's a little extra chicken poop in the chicken run? The other chickens can scratch through it and get some use out of that food that otherwise would have gone to waste. This tub was something we just had around already. It was actually our very first chicken brooder. It proved to be way too small for a chicken brooder for us, but this is a real good use for it.